Hey YouTubers, I thought I'd do a quick video on one of my favorite firearms. Happens to actually be my Taurus Model 92. I've owned this gun since roughly 1997. I love the gun. I've had great luck with it. I think it looks fantastic. And one of the most important things I have to say is that it's never let me down. I mean that literally. I have shot this gun probably in excess of 2,000 times, and I have never had a single misfire, not a single failure to feed, not a single letdown. I don't think I can really say that about any other pistol I've ever owned, let alone any semi-automatic firearm, period. But real quick, before we get too far into the video, magazine is definitely not in it, and as you can probably see right in there, it is clear, not loaded. One of the things I like about the gun is it does have a factory decocker on it. For those of you that don't actually know what that is, basically pull down this lever on this firearm and it's going to block the firing pin from actually hitting the bullet, even though there's not a bullet in the chamber right now. You pull down on that, it safely decocks the gun. Nice feature. Another beautiful thing about it, if you've watched any of my other videos, I'm a southpaw. It's really important to me that it has an ambi safety on it. This happens to be an ambi safety and decocker. I always look for those features on a firearm. I want to be able to utilize most of the functions of a gun. Being a lefty, it's important to me. It's something I look for. As a general rule, I won't buy one unless it actually has that. So those of you out there that are southpaws, it's a nice feature to have. Those of you that aren't, still works just fine. Things that I really like about the gun, fit and finish on it. I think it's great. I think it's a good looking gun. It's clean. All the cuts on it look real good. The tolerances are smooth. It's a smooth action gun. Works really, really well. I like it. A few things that I've actually changed on the guns over the years is I have replaced the grips. Actually, I've replaced the grips, honestly, two or three times. Apparently, I like changing the look of my gun a little bit here and there. This is what I happen to have on it now. I also did change the sight out. I changed it to a adjustable sight. It originally had just a two-dot plain sight on it. It was all right, but I prefer having an adjustable one. The only other thing I've actually changed on it, and there's nobody behind this camera, so I'm comfortable with doing this, but if you look right there, on this particular Taurus, it actually came with what I believe to be a black nylon guide rod. I replaced that with a steel one. They seem to have gone back and forth over the years what the actual firearm comes with. It is actually a factory one, just not the one that actually came with this particular gun. I replaced it because I like the looks a little bit better, and it just seemed like a good idea durability wise. I didn't replace it because it needed to be replaced. I just feel it's fair to note that I didn't have any failures because it was in there. I just like the idea of having metal instead of plastic. A real brief history on this particular firearm by Taurus. I can't speak for any other Taurus firearms. It's the only one I've ever owned. Taurus seems to kind of have a mixed bag as far as people like them, hate them, think they're awful, think they're great. I can only speak for this particular one. And the history on how Taurus ended up making a gun that, you know, looks an awful lot like the Beretta, which I think is called the M9 in military jargon, and it is also called the Beretta Model 92. This happens to be the full size. What happened is in the 1970s, I believe, Beretta ended up getting a contract with the Brazilian government to manufacture firearms for their military. One of the requirements of that was that they actually build a factory in Brazil and manufacture the firearms in Brazil. Once that contract ended, which was in the 1980s sometime, Beretta moved out and Taurus ended up acquiring the factory. And by the factory, I mean the building, the dies, the tooling and blueprints. Even some of the workers, from what I understand, actually stayed working with Taurus. So Taurus was in business making the Model 92. A few things that they changed over the years. Initially, I don't believe it came with the decocker at all. It just came with a safety. They moved where the decocker and safety mechanism is compared to on the Beretta. It actually fits my hand a little bit better, so I think that's an improvement. Some of the newer Tauruses, in fact, I think all the newer ones actually come with a full rail here. Again, this is an older one, therefore it doesn't have that. I don't know if I mentioned, I believe I purchased this somewhere around 1997. Interesting to note that it's actually the only pistol that I've owned that long. I only mention that because, well, I feel it's that good of a firearm. I love it. I don't actually foresee myself ever getting rid of it. I find the fit and finish on it to be fantastic, inside and out. It's overall just a good gun. I'll do a real quick tear down on it so you can actually see what the insides look like. I'm not going to detail out the field strip because there's a million videos out there for field stripping this particular firearm, as well as its Beretta cousin. So real quick though, you've probably actually seen this done in the movies about a million times. Comes apart real fast, real easy. It's a little bit dirty. I didn't clean it last time we took it to the range. I don't know if you can really even see, but as far as, you know, tooling marks and fit and finish, it's really good. Again, that's that guide rod that I think I mentioned to you that I just changed it out for a steel one. I like that a little bit better. It is a factory spring as well. Barrel. Still got a nice polish on it. A little dirty on the end there. That's embarrassing. But I don't know how well you can actually see. But overall, build quality, I think, is on par with any other good manufacturer out there. And putting her back together is a real easy process. I'm not going to go into major details in this video. Maybe in another one I will, but honestly, there's so many other videos out there detailing that same thing. I don't really see the need to do it, but bear with me one second here while I put her back together. Really is pretty much just as simple as that. In conclusion, would I recommend this firearm to somebody? You know, I definitely would. You know, there's a lot of details you would want to work out on your own. You know, is how's the gun feel in your hands? Do you want a full-size gun? This is a large firearm. It's not something that's going to be real easy to, you know, conceal carry, anything like that. But if you're considering a full-size firearm, you're considering a Beretta, you know, I would definitely give the Taurus at least a second look. Two reasons for that. One is because I think it's a very good gun. Two, it's going to be $100, $150 cheaper than the actual Beretta. That buys a lot of ammo or some other magazines. Speaking of magazine, I have to mention real briefly, Taurus sends you two 15-round magazines. At least it did when I purchased this firearm. I live in the fantastic state of New York. I mean that a little bit sarcastically. Where they decided that civilians can't safely have a 15-round magazine. Isn't that nice? So I had to get rid of my 15-round magazines and buy a bunch of 10-rounders. So if you live in New York, this is what you're stuck with. Pretty much the rest of the country, you're going to get a couple of 15-round magazines, as far as I know. If you like this video, I would love it if you'd give me a thumbs up. I do it simply because I enjoy it. I'm not a professional. Please take the information I have in there as such. Do your own research. Including probably other YouTube videos are a great spot to try. Love the gun. Love how it holds. It's great. Thanks for watching. I hope it was helpful. Have a great day.